Hello students, I am Nisha Nair. In this video, we are going to learn about elastomers, examples for elastomers, application of elastomers in our day-to-day life. So, what is elastomers? Elastomers are those materials whose length can be increased 5 to 10% without breaking it, or it can return to its original positions even after withdrawing the force. Means when we stretch a material, and after giving the force stretching, it doesn't break down. And after leaving that force, it returns to its original position or original volume. Such materials are called as elastomers. So, the best example for elastomers are rubber. Now, rubber here can be classified into two. One is natural rubber and another is synthetic rubber. Now, natural rubbers are obtained from in the form of a milky form from the leaves of trees. It is obtained from the trees. Now, for synthetic rubber is prepared in the laboratory. It is completely prepared in the laboratory. So, it is known as a synthetic rubber. Now, in natural rubber, we can see a monomer unit as an isoprene molecule. And for synthetic rubber, such monomer units like isoprenes are prepared in the laboratory as organophthalates. Now, in natural rubber, the strength is less compared to the synthetic rubber. The strength of synthetic rubber is more compared to the natural rubber. And the fourth thing is that the elasticity of natural numbers decreases with increase of times. As the time increases, as the time grown, the elasticity of natural rubber will withdraw or it will be decreased. Why? For synthetic rubber, the elasticity will not lose according to the lapse of time. The elasticity, there will be no change of elasticity properties, even the time lapse changes. So, synthetic rubbers are more tough and more strong than compared to the natural rubber. And example for synthetic rubbers are Buna N, Buna S rubbers. These are the monomer unit in the Buna N, and Buna S rubber is butadiene, styrene, acrylonitriles. And they are completely prepared in the laboratory and they give a fantastic properties like a strength and elasticity, and they are used in the wide application. Now, we know the natural rubber doesn't have a good property. So, to increase the property of rubber, we are using a process called as a vulcanization. Vulcanization of rubber. Why we are doing vulcanization for a rubber? Because we have to increase the properties of natural rubber. So, to increase the properties of natural rubber, what we do? We take the milk form which is getting from the lattice of trees of rubber. That milky form of rubber is mixed with 30% of sulfuric acid. Here diode sulfuric acid is used, and this diode sulfuric acid will combine with this monomer unit, and the sulfur in the sulfuric acid create a branches between the polymer units. Here sulfur will help to form a cross-link structure for this polymer, and this cross-link structure will increase the strengthened unit of this natural rubber. So, the sulfur will help to strengthen the natural rubber, hence its properties will have a wide changes after the vulcanization, and such vulcanized rubbers are used in many application level. So, to have an application level or to increase the application of level of rubber, we need to do the vulcanization of natural rubber. After doing the vulcanizations of natural rubber, we can use that rubber in different ways. So, what is the vulcanization process? It is just a treatment of natural rubber with sulfuric acid, and the sulfur helps to have a cross-link structure of rubber, and which strengthen its property, and it can be widely used in different applications.